Welcome back to State of the Union. We are here with Republican Senator John Thune of South Dakota and Democratic Senator Chris Murphy of Connecticut. Let me start with the elections and with you, Senator Thune. Elections have consequences. You all had a terrific election. You are going to be in the majority on the Senate side, already in the majority on the House side. I want to let you hear something that Senator Rand Paul, a very visible member of your Republican caucus, said on the night that Mitch McConnell won his election about what's ahead.
It will be 2 long years till we get to replace this president. Until then, we can and we will send him legislation. Under Mitch McConnell's leadership, we will send the president bill after bill until he wearies of it.
Senator Thune, is that the plan for the Republican leadership, is to just keep sending the president bills? He didn't say it, but the implication was bills that he probably won't sign.
Candy, the plan is to try and get the Senate opened up and working again and have some votes. You know, the House has sent almost 400 pieces of legislation to the Senate that have been collecting dust on Senator Reid's desk, and 40 of those deal with jobs in the economy, which is where we think the focus ought to be. And so I guess what I would argue is that we can do big things in a time of divided government. That's been true in the past. Social Security reform, tax reform, welfare reform, balanced budgets. There have been lots of examples where you have Democrats and Republicans, a Democrat in the White House or Republican in some cases, working with the other party in Congress to do some big things. And that would be my goal and my objective. We will
can
be sending
name
legislation
something big
to
you
president.
Think you can do?
Well, I'd love to see us do something in the area of tax reform. I'd love to see us do something in the area. I think initially, at least coming out of the gate, things on jobs, trade policy, energy policy. Energy gives us a very competitive edge. It's very important to the economy.
Senator,
and that's something I think that the president, I hope, would sign into law. We know that to get anything done, we have to get a presidential signature. But we've got to get the Senate and the House moving again and actually producing legislation that we can send to the president.
Senator,
he's going to have to make a decision.
Senator Murphy, do you hear anything there? You think there's some commonality there that you all could get done and get to the president something that he might sign?
Sure. And of course, the reality is that under the way that the rules are constructed in the Senate today, you can't actually get anything to the president's desk without some members of the now minority Democratic caucus supporting it. So it's got to be bipartisan in nature to begin with. But yeah, listen, there's been bipartisan agreement there to be had for a number of years. And I think tax reform is a perfect example. Infrastructure improvement. And there are Republicans and Democrats that want to move forward on a major infrastructure bill. And there are some good bipartisan ideas out there, like an infrastructure bank. I have legislation with Senator Corker to put more money into the trust fund. So I absolutely am optimistic about our ability to move something like tax reform, something like infrastructure to the president's desk. And I'm not initially worried about the Senate Republicans. We've been able to work together in the past. It's really a question of whether John Boehner is going to be able to convince the Tea Party crowd in the House of Representatives to go along with some of the compromises that we may be able to forge in the Senate.
Okay, but this has sort of always been the problem, hasn't it, is that Republicans have said there's all these bills passed by the House that are stacked up on Harry Reid's desk and he won't take a vote on them. And the Democrats say, you know, boy, the Republicans can't pass anything over there. You all don't want to consider the same bills.
Right. Well, I think
the challenge for
the end of...
Go ahead, John.
Well, at the end of the day, I mean, you do have to figure out how to find that critical mass to pass legislation, and the House has done it. In some cases, they've been bills with pretty big bipartisan support, and as Chris mentioned, there are a number of things on which there's pretty broad bipartisan support in the Senate. We ought to focus on those things, try and move those things. Let's put up some legislative accomplishments, which I think will help build trust to enable us to do some bigger things down the road. Tax reform, entitlement reform, things that would really jumpstart our economy are things that we ought to be focused on. But there are things right now coming from the House, sitting awaiting action in the Senate, that enjoy a considerable amount of bipartisan support.
Senator Murphy, do you think that your Senate leadership, which will be in charge of the lame duck session coming up, will want to do the confirmation process of the Attorney General?
Well, I can only speak for myself. I hope that we do move forward on that confirmation process. And in fact, we have a long backload of other presidential appointees and ambassadors.
Even though Republicans want to wait until the next session.
Well, I think it's important that we have an attorney general, and so I would like to see us move forward. I have not spoken to Senator Reid about his intentions, but I would like to see us move forward. I think this is an important post, and I think we should have somebody on the ground there sooner rather than later.
And do you want Senator Reid to remain minority leader of your party?
I do. I ultimately think that Senator Reid can work with Senator McConnell. And really, I think John identified the issue. The issue is whether Republicans in the House and the Senate really want to work together moving forward. If I was a political consultant for Republicans, I would advise them to compromise with Democrats and move some pieces of legislation through the process. With the exception of 2012, every political election that I've been a part of has been a change election because people are just sick and tired of nothing getting done. If nothing gets done over the next 2 years, well, then Democrats are going to be swept back into power in 2016. So I think it's in the interest of Republicans to sit down at the table and get some things done. That'll actually help them.
Senator Thune, talking about the confirmation process coming up for the Attorney General, I can't remember if there's a way for Republicans to block the confirmation process, but your leadership has already said they want to do this in the next session of Congress. Is there a way to block it? Should it be blocked in the lame duck?
Well, since the Democrats changed the rules, it's very hard, but I think it would be in the best interest of the country and the Congress to wait and do this next year under regular order, Candy. Loretta Lynch will get fair consideration, but there's a process. There's hearings and everything that goes with that. We've got to move a funding bill. We've got to prevent some tax increases, a number of things that have to be done before the end of the year. And Eric Holder said he's not going anywhere soon, so it's not like the position isn't going to be filled. It's an important position. It's one that needs to be filled. And we will give the president's nominee every consideration, but would like to do that, consider that next year when the new Congress is seated.
Senator Thune, Senator Murphy, thank you both so much. Come see us in studio next time when you're back in Washington. I appreciate your time.
Thanks, Candy.
Sounds good. Thanks, Candy.
Up next.